Flavor Some family, and welcome to our channel. Today we're making a Persian beef and split pea stew. This stew can be served with rice, but we're mainly focusing on how to prepare the stew.
دوستان عزیز امروز غذایی که در نظر گرفتم خورشت قیمه است. این خورشت با گوشت و لپه و یه تعداد از مواد دیگه که دونه دونه براتون نشون میدم درست میشه. هم میتونیم از گوشت گوسفند هم از گوشت گاو استفاده کنیم. این گوشتا رو یک دفعه من میجوشونم و خالی میکنم آبشو. بعد دفعه دوم گوشت رو نیم پز میکنم با یه مقدار پیاز و فلفل سیاه و همچنین لیموی خشک عمانی و چند تا دونه هم دارچین.
Okay, so to prepare this stew, you want to basically have 1 to 2 pounds of either beef or lamb. It doesn't really matter. You boil it in in 2 to 3 cups of water for about 10 minutes to get rid of that unpleasant flavor of the meat. And then you want to add 1 onion, 2 to 3 dried limes or limes, and 2 to 3 sticks of cinnamon. And then you add about 4 to 6 cups of water and let it cook for about 30 minutes.
این در حدود 15 دقیقه این میجوشه، این نیم پخت میشه گوشت را.
So we don't want it fully cooked. So now that you've added the other ingredients, you want to let it cook for actually 15 minutes, not 30. And the meat will not be 100% cooked because we're going to cook it later with other ingredients. So what do we want the heat to be on? Medium heat?
اول اجازه میدیم این بجوشه. بعد از اینکه به جوش افتاد اینو تقریبا دما رو نصف میکنیم، روی دمای متوسط میذاریم، در دیگه میبندیم تا این نیم پخت بشه.
So now you want to let the water to come to a boil and then adjust the heat to medium low and let it cook for 15 minutes with the lid on.
خب دوستان ما گوشتمون تقریبا نیم پخت شد. گوشتا رو در آوردم. بعد همینطور لیمو رو که میخواستم لیمورم در آوردم از توش. بقیه مواد رو آهسته اینجا صاف میکنم که این آب گوشت رو من داشته باشم.
So once everything is semi-cooked, you want to take out the dried limes and the pieces of meat, and then you want to sift the rest of the ingredients because we don't need to include the onions, the peppercorns and cinnamon sticks in the stew. So we will basically remove them and then keep the broth, as you can see that's underneath. Yep. Okay.
فلفل سیاه رو میبینید، من اینو پودرش رو نریختم توی خورشت، باعث میشه رنگ خورشت یه ذره تیره میشه. اینا رو فقط همینطوری میجوشونیم، بعد اینا رو میندازیم میره.
So the reason we used peppercorns instead of ground pepper is because if you use ground pepper, it will slightly change the color of your broth and make it darker. So we want to preferably use peppercorns.
دوستان عزیز یه دونه پیاز بزرگ رو من خرد کردم، نگینی ریختم اینجا و سرخش کردم. بعد الان نوبت اینه که گوشت اضافه کنم، گوشت نیم پختم و توی این سرخ کنم.
So you want to cube I'm just waiting for the meat to... What a loud noise. Oh my goodness. Okay, so we want to fry 1 onion. I basically cubed the onion and then you fry it until it's somewhat golden on medium low heat. And then you want to add your beef stew. And you're trying to saute it. It doesn't have to become fried or anything because we're gonna cook it later with the yellow split peas.
خب الان در حال سرخ کردن گوشت هستیم. اجازه میدیم گوشت ما کاملا سرخ بشه. بعد از اینکه گوشت سرخ شد، لپه رو اضافه میکنیم.
And how long will this take for the meat to basically be ready for?
تقریبا میشه گفت 8 دقیقه کافیه.
So you're just sauteing it for about 8 minutes. That's all.
خب یه قاشق چای خوری ما زردچوبه اضافه میکنیم.
We're adding one tablespoon of turmeric powder.
Teaspoon.
One teaspoon of turmeric powder. Can they use fresh turmeric?
اگه در دسترس داشته باشیم، همه با در دسترس نیست. اگه در دسترس داشته باشیم، چه بهتر. دوستان الان من
If it's available to you, you can definitely use fresh turmeric.
خب الان لپه رو اضافه کردم. لپه به خاطر اینکه اگر سرخ نشه وقتی که میپزه این باعث میشه که لپه وا میره. له میشه تو خورش. پس ما لپه رو یه مقدار تفت میدیم اینجا.
Okay, and how much split peas do we have?
One cup,
okay. So we have 1 cup of yellow split peas that we just washed. You don't need to soak it in water or anything because they cook pretty fast. And we want to saute it in the same pot with the meat and the oil and the onion because yellow split peas can get mushy very quickly. And this method of sauteing will somewhat prevent it from become mushy once everything is cooked at the end.
خب لیموامون هم اضافه میکنیم. لیمو ها که نیم پس شده باعث میشه که طعم خوبی، طعم ترشی به غذامون بده.
And we just added our cooked dried limes. We cooked it initially. And we just added because it truly, the citric flavor intensifies the flavor of the stew.
خب الان آب گوشتی رو که صاف کردیم اینجا اضافه میکنیم به موادمون.
And finally, you want to add your beef stew that we stored from the initial cooking process. The beef stew has been, has so much flavor because we added cinnamon and limes and peppercorns. So it's super flavorful and that's why we want to cook the meat with its broth.
خب دوستان عزیز الان در قابلمه‌مون رو میذاریم و اجازه میدیم اینا با هم حدود نزدیک 1 ساعت توی دمای به حساب میدیم دمای متوسط این پخته بشه.
So we want to put the lid on and let this cook on medium heat for about an hour. And since this is in a pressure cooker, do we just put the lid on or are we gonna actually pressurize it?
نه فقط در قابلمه رو میذاریم دیگه نیازی نیست که به حساب سوپاپش هم بذاریم. فقط در قابلمه رو که بذاریم من نمیخوام زیاد قابلمه به حساب استفاده کنم که باعث شستن زیاد قابلمه های متفاوت بشه. همین رو استفاده میکنم ولی درش رو میذارم. فقط یه چیزی هم توجه داشته باشید که این باید جوش بیاد. بعد از اینکه جوش آمد دما رو نصف میکنیم. دمای به حساب دمای پایین تر از دمای بالا میدیم میذاریم. دمای کم میذاریم و بعد از اینکه درش رو گذاشتیم اجازه میدیم 1 ساعت بپزه.
So, we want to let this cook for about an hour on medium-low heat. However, you want to bring this to a boil first and then lower the heat. It's important to note that for the second round of cooking, you don't need to use a pressure cooker because we're just going to put the lid on and we're not going to pressurize the pot at all. So after an hour, your stew will be ready to be to serve.
این رو یه مقدار سرخ میکنیم تو روغن برای اینکه هم کمش بهتر میشه هم اینکه رنگی بهتری به غذا میده.
And how much tomato paste is this?
دو قاشق غذاخوری پر.
So we have about 2 tablespoons of tomato paste with some vegetable oil. You want to basically put this on very low heat and you stir it for a little bit until it starts to sizzle. Then you turn it off. This will increase the intensity of the tomato's flavor basically. And also it creates a beautiful color. Okay, so now it has been about an hour since everything has been cooking. And now we're just adding the tomato paste mixture to our stew. You want to stir it around and on low heat? Okay, so we're just after adding the tomato paste mixture, we're just gonna let this cook on low heat for just about 10 minutes, which is more than enough for this particular stew. And as you can see, the tomato paste just gave it an amazing color.
و این زعفران آب کرده است این بنا به دلخواهه اگر داشتید در محیطتون میتونید استفاده کنید تقریبا یه قاشق و نیم زعفران آب کرده است.
So next you want to add about 1.5 tablespoons of saffron water. So you basically add about 1/4 teaspoon saffron threads to half a cup of hot water. You let it rest for about 15 minutes and it will create this vibrant color. And saffron is an amazing spice that has a vibrant, you know, warm color. And although this step is completely optional, you don't have to add saffron water, but if you have it, I think it even makes your stew better.
دوستان نمک رو در آخر تقریبا 10 دقیقه مونده با آخر اضافه می کنیم چون گوشت ما گوشت گاو بود این نمک باعث میشه که اجازه نده که گوشت گاو کاملا پخته بشه و سریع پخته بشه نمک رو اضافه کردم در ظرف رو میذارم تا 10 دقیقه بعد هم برای تزیین این سیب زمینی سرخ کرده استفاده می کنم که بعدا اونو نشون میدم بهتون که چطور آماده کنید و تزیین کنید
And the last ingredient here is about 1 teaspoon of sea salt. We add the salt at last as the last ingredient because if you add the salt pretty early, it will prevent your meat to become cooked, if you know what I mean. So now it's just gonna cook for an additional 10 minutes and your stew is done.
خب سیب زمینی رو داریم سرخ میکنیم ما 2 قسمت کردیم سیب زمینی رو یکی به این رنگ که همون رنگ طبیعیه در نظر میگیریم برای تزیین قشنگتر میشه یکی هم یه مقدار ما زردچوبه اضافه میکنیم به این یکی که رنگش زرد میشه و به حساب شکل قشنگتری میده به دو طرف
So we want to serve some French fries on the side and basically you know cook your French fries I mean fry your French fries you know just like how you would normally do and then you want to divide it in half and add a little bit of turmeric powder because we want half of it to be more golden than the other half. And this is only for visual purposes. I think it's aesthetically pleasant to see 2 different colors of French fries on the stew.
خب غذای ما آماده شد. این خورشت قیمه رو معمولا با برنج سرو میکنم. من برنجم رو آبکش کردم بعد با زعفران تزیین کردم بسته به میل شماست میتونید کته کنید و اگر نیاز به این دارید که دستور پختن برنجو که چطور میشه برنجو اینطوری قشنگ و دون در آورد من در دستورالعمل‌های قبلی اینو کاملا توضیح دادم میتونید به حساب سرچ کنید پیدا کنید این رو و حتما بپزید و لذت ببرید.
Okay, beautiful people. As you can see, our split pea beef stew is ready to be served. It's usually served with rice. This is steamed Persian rice with saffron, or I should say saffron liquid. The recipe for this particular rice can be found on our channel, so if you just search through the channel, you'll definitely find it. You definitely want to layer the stew with French fries, or what you can do is, you can buy readily available French fries from a grocery store and just top it with that. I wish you guys were here so you could smell the saffron and the stew. As you remember, we added a little bit of saffron water to the stew, so this stew smells just exquisite.
خب دوستان نگاه کنید چقدر خوش رنگ و قشنگه و میتونید یه مقدارم از این سیب زمینی ها اینطوری روش بریزید و نوش جان کنید.
I hope you guys enjoyed watching this recipe. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, smash the like button, and share this video with your family and friends. I love you all and Happy New Year!